Hey everyone, a question that I got quite a few times was how to shorten Shimano brake hose when installing new brakes. So here is how it's done. This is a set of Deore XT M8000 brakes, but this procedure can be used on any current Shimano brakes. The few tools needed are a vise grip, you need an X-Acto knife with a good blade, you need an 8mm wrench, a piece of wood, a hammer, and then a couple of pieces that will come with the new brake set. The yellow blocks are used to clamp onto the brake hose. Then you have the olive and the insert. I will show you how to use them later. These are specific to the type of brake hose you have. BH90 is the most current one. The bleeding tool from Shimano is nothing more than a funnel. And finally, you're going to need some Shimano hydraulic mineral oil. You can buy this in smaller containers as well. If the brake hose is externally routed on your bike, just go ahead and install the caliper, then run it nicely using the posts provided all the way up to the handlebar, where you will be ready to start trimming it to the appropriate length. For a bike like this that has the brake hose internal to the frame, I'm gonna have to trim that hose right now before I can even route it correctly. You would try to create a 90 degree angle here, so try to cut it as straight as you can, and you just push down on the blade. Done. Having the hose routed through the frame all the way up still gives me plenty of slack here at the head tube. The 1 meter long hose of the front brake is plenty, whether you install it moto style like you see it here, or whether you install your front brake on the left hand side. The routing of this hose is very simple. You just go through that clip and then to the inside of the lower leg of the fork. You don't need the grips here. I just push them in temporarily to give me an idea of where I'm gonna wanna have the lever. These are designed for one finger braking, so I usually install them about half an inch in from the end of the grip, just like this. Next, we're disconnect this brake hose from the master cylinder. So what I'm going to do is just angle my lever about 45 degrees up, because this is filled with oil, and once I disconnect the hose, I don't want that oil to start leaking from it. What's called the connecting nut is protected by this rubber boot or cover. So slide this off, and then that's the connecting nut. You're gonna need the 8mm open wrench. This is normal thread, so righty tighty, lefty loosey. It's really tight. And just undo it. Just slide this down onto the hose. You're gonna need it later. Pull on the hose, it's gonna come out. Time to figure out how much hose you need. Front brake is fairly easy because you have two fixed points. One is here, this clip on the fork. The other one is your master cylinder. This is gonna flex as the suspension compresses. However, this is the worst case scenario with the fork fully extended. So if you measure it to the shortest length that you want right now, you'll be fine. I usually leave something like this. It's gonna be right here under the handlebar. So if you're unsure, make sure you measure this a few times. Needless to say, once you cut it, it's cut, you can't have it back. This is where I use this piece of wood again. And I usually put it right on top of the stem. I have my hose marked right here. Next, you're gonna grab the olive and just slide it over the hose. The insert goes right in the middle of the hose here, but you have to push it in all the way. And this is where you're gonna use that yellow block with the vise grips, and the insert is already right there in the middle. Take the hammer and just pound it. Once you're done, you want it to be flush to the top of the hose. So nicely lined up right now, insert, olive, connecting bolt, and the rubber cover. Shimano recommends to put a tiny bit of grease right here on the outside of the olive and the thread of this bolt. Grab the 8mm wrench, and as you're pushing onto the hose, you're gonna start to tighten this up. Keep pressure onto the hose. This is 5 to 6 Nm, so it's not a whole lot. Don't go crazy on this one. Last thing to do, just push that rubber cover back on. For the rear brake, I have to measure the hose as well. Also remember, if you have any port covers, you have to install those first. So the worst case scenario in this situation would be with the handlebar twisted, something like that. So make sure you have a little bit of slack. At that extreme, is not as bad when you're turning the handlebars the other direction, and then trim it and install it just like I showed you for the front brake. If you're switching hoses at this time, that is from left to right, it's even more important to have your brake levers angled up like this, because at some point you're gonna have both hoses disconnected. So you want to prevent oil from leaking out of those master cylinders as much as you can. Rest of the procedure, it's exactly the same. For this next step, start with the lever kind of parallel to the ground, and that is one of the bleeding ports of your brake system. The second one, it's right here on the caliper. It is the one covered with that little rubber cap. Enemy of any brake system is air trapped inside, and this is no different. And if you think about what we've done, we've definitely introduced a little bit of air here by disconnecting the hoses, and that air is now trapped in there and is going to prevent your brakes from working properly. With the bike on the stand, remove the wheel and replace the pads with this bleeding spacer or bleeding block. Just use that same pad pin to hold it in place. You're most probably going to have to loosen up those caliper bolts because the bleeding block fits in from the opposite side. There it goes. You might be tempted not to install the bleeding block when you're just shortening hoses, but I would strongly recommend you do, otherwise you're gonna overfill the system with fluid. With the lever somewhat horizontal, just use a 2.5 millimeter hex to remove that top bleeding port. As you take that out, make sure you remove that tiny O-ring as well. Tiny O-ring that you're gonna find here on at the bottom of the funnel as well. The funnel screws in pretty much where you took that screw out. Just snug and stop. You're going to remove this oil stop as well. You don't need it now. Pour some oil into the funnel, maybe about half of it, and start pumping your brake lever. As you do that, you're gonna see air bubbles coming out. If you were a bit afraid and didn't tighten up this connecting bolt enough before, as you start pumping your lever here, it's gonna start leaking. So just tighten it up a little bit more. Next, you might wanna just take your wrench or your screwdriver and just do a little bit of this. You are trying to encourage those little bubbles just to come up to the top, where by pumping your lever you're gonna get all the air out. Loosen up the lever on the handlebar and just go, see, I just angled it a little bit and there was a bit more air coming out. Do the same with the lever angled about 30 degrees the other way. Use that oil stopper just to plug the bottom of the funnel, and now you can undo it without having all that oil pouring out. As you take out the funnel, make sure it comes out with that little O-ring, because next you're gonna replace that top bleed screw that has its own O-ring. Tighten it to about 2 Nm, so that's not a lot. Spray a little bit of isopropyl alcohol and wipe that lever clean. I have an older video talking about when and how to replace the brake pads. Repeat the same procedure for your rear brake and go out and make sure you do a proper break-in of your brake system, especially if it's a brand new one. A brake system with no air in it will give you that solid feel at the lever that would never allow the lever to go all the way down to the handlebar. A full system bleed requires a couple more steps, but 99% of the time, if you're just shortening hoses, this is all you need. And that is pretty much the end of my video, folks. If you have questions, let me know in the comments below. If you haven't done so, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. And until next time, I will see you on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.